Bismillah, walhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man la. Rabbi shahli sadri wa yassirli amri wa hlul uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Afan Siddiqui. I'm from YM, New Jersey, specifically YM South Jersey, and I will be serving as the moderator today. I hope and pray that everyone is doing well, staying at home, safe and healthy, and has enjoyed and taken a lot out of the sessions thus far. On behalf of young Muslims and ICNA, I'd like to welcome you all to this online symposium and to the third session of today. So without further ado, introducing Sheikh Yasir Birjas. Sheikh Yasir Birjas started his career in electronic engineering in the UAE, then graduated class valedictorian with highest honors from the Islamic University of Medina's College of Sharia. He currently serves as the imam at the Valley Ranch Islamic Center. And here's Sheikh Yasir Birjas with Changing Minds from Passivity to Activity.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته الحمد لله رب العالمين صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا ثم ما بعد My dear brothers and sisters, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you safe, ya رب العالمين keep you guarded and protected. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those who are ill that Allah will give them quick shifa and recovery. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this moment that He would rid this world from this disease and this virus. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower us with His mercy, with His rahmah, to overlook our to forgive us our sins, our shortcomings, and accept from us our good deeds, ya Rabbil Alameen. My dear brothers and sisters, as we live right now in the COVID-19 era and lifestyle, a new lifestyle, being at home for more hours than we usually do, spending time with each other, a lot of people now just looking at, okay, what can I do with all this time? What is it exactly that I can really do? Before we even decide on what we could do, let's see what we did before so we could see how we need really to change our mind from being passivist to being activist. A lot of things happen for a reason, subhanAllah. Everything in this world happens for a reason because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in control and Allah azza wa jalla has hikmah for everything. Now, who could even imagine that an unseen virus could bring the entire world to what we could say today, a complete standstill. The entire world goes down on its knees because they could do nothing about it. SubhanAllah, many of these nations always brag about the strong economy they have, the number of jobs they've created, and the military power, and they compare themselves to other nations in regards to such and such technology and this and that, and all of these things all of a sudden become completely irrelevant. Because we've seen that the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came in the form of such an unseen creature like this, just brought all these words to realize He is in control, subhanahu wa ta'ala. See, Allah Azza wa Jal says, ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس. Now, this corruption is becoming very, very common and very, very obvious. في البر والبحر, inland and in the sea, بما كسبت أيدي الناس, because of what the hand of man had earned. Why? لذيقهم بعض الذي عمل. So they can taste what of their hand has committed, has earned. لعلهم يرجعون. So that might reflect and return back to Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters, in Surah Yunus, chapter 10, ayah 24 and 25, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to us about the example of this life and how, as humans in this time, we become complacent to a lifestyle that is not designed, that's not supposed to be the lifestyle of a true believer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا مَثَلُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا, the example of the life of this world, كَمَا إِنْ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ, just the example of the rain when it comes down from heavens, فَاخْتَلَطَ بِهِ نَبَاتُ الْأَرْضِ, get mixed with the herbs and the plants of on earth. مِمَّا يَأْكُلُ النَّاسُ وَالْأَنْعَامُ, among these things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grow for people to consume and eat, and also for their livestock. حَتَّى, and that's now the meaning of it. حَتَّى إِذَا أَخَذَتِ الْأَرْضُ زُخْرُفَهَا وَزَيَّنَتْ, until the day comes when the earth takes its full adornment, وَزَيَّنَتْ, becomes so beautified for the people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَظَنَّ أَهْلُهَا أَنَّهُمْ قَادِرُونَ عَلَيْهَا. That's when the people think they already take control of everything. قَادِرُونَ عَلَيْهَا, like now they're overcoming everything and they're becoming in control of everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَتَاهَا أَمْرُنَا لَيْلًا أَوْ نَهَارًا. The command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes to this earth during the day or during the night. Like it could come anytime. فَجَعَلْنَاهَا حَصِيدًا. And we made it حَصِيد, which means just like after the harvest. If you've ever been in a field where after the harvest, how it looks like, that's exactly how the earth would look like, subhanAllah. In time like ours, you go to the streets, they're empty. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَالْ كَأَلْ لَمْ تَغْنَ بِالْأَمْسِ, just like as if yesterday, it has absolutely no beauty or no culpability of anything. like completely. If you look at our time, our economy, our lifestyle, our streets, our shops, everywhere, as if it wasn't so prosperous, you know, just a few weeks ago, subhanAllah, everything changed. And that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showing the power that He is the one who's in control. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking us what? To reflect and return back to Him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who reflect to Rabbil Alameen. My dear brothers and sisters, the world went into some sense of like crazy attitude of narcissism. Like everybody, every nation, everyone thinks that they are in control of everything. The radical level of individualism. On personal level, on society's level, this whole idea of everybody's now just, you know, kind of looking for their own nationalism, their country, their culture, their kind, and all that stuff. Going back again to all these divisions amongst human beings, we're not supposed to be the case. All of this led people to become so engulfed into personal goals, whether on a national level, on regional level, community level, or even on individual levels. All of that divided the people, which is not supposed to be the case. That reminds me to the extent that the society reached a level of a'udhu billah from going all the way into this dunya that forget about the akhirah. When the cloning of Dolly the sheep became news, and people were talking about this as if, here we go, we now know exactly the art of creation, a'udhu billah. I remember I was walking one of the airports. And I remember at the time, still before, of course, most of the magazines went into the internet, I saw a magazine cover. And right on the magazine cover, they have the sheep's image on that magazine. They say, now God has a rival. And wallahi, when I read this statement, I was just like, a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan rajim. I got so scared. The arrogance the people can get to, because they thought they just, you know, cloned a sheep, or clone whatever they clone, and now they claim that they are now God has a rival. A'udhu billah. It's because of this, people, unfortunately, they start become too radical into their individualism, living for this world and for this dunya, and forgot completely about the vision that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created for them. You see, my dear brothers, we're not here telling people to quit, you know, living for the dunya. Astaghfirullah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to enjoy the dunya as well. As a matter of fact, Allah azza wa jalla says, قَالْ وَابْتَغِ فِي مَا أَتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ وَلَا تَنُسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. That you need to look for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed you with. Seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in matters of the akhirah. But then don't forget about your share from this dunya. So we've been asked to take share in this dunya. But what we have seen lately in the past few years with the age of social media, people went so much into the dunya that they forgot that they really have an akhirah they have to answer for. See, especially if you look at social media, we had the, people became unfortunately copycats. And that's when they become pacifists. And we see things, we just follow it. We don't even think for ourselves. No critical thinking whatsoever. Remember the age of the vines, when people start having vines and just kind of posting things for 6-7 seconds just to make a laugh or make a joke? We're back again to TikTok today in the same way. And we have, if you remember before, the trends on social media as well. And then you have the influencer, we have the YouTubers, you have all these things that happen, subhanAllah. All of that made people agreeable to whatever is out there, we just do it. You remember the trends when people start doing things harmful even? And there's just, some people even, they got sick and some people, they got hurt because of that stuff. Astaghfirullah. All of this. When the Prophet ﷺ told us in the hadith, لَا تَكُنْ إِمَّا. Don't be an imma, which means like, don't be a copycat. Like, whatever people do, just do it, because just do it. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet says, in ahsan an-nas wa an tuhsin wa an asaw an tusiu. Don't be like them. If they do good, you do good. If they do bad, you do bad. Instead, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, walakin wattin wa anfusakum. You need to adapt. In ahsan an-nas an tuhsin. If they do well, do better. And if they do bad, still you need to do good. Meaning, don't just be a copycat. Our society went into this complacent culture. We become pacifist. Whatever happens out there, we just become agreeable, unfortunately. We forget that as Muslims, as believers, we have a mission in this life. We have a mission in this world. So what I'm going to share with you, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to share with you a few things, five things from an ayah. One single ayah in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah azza wa jal is calling us to move from being pacifist to become activist. From being complacent to being really people who have a mission to do things differently and not just following a trend, instead become an outlier and stand out among the people because you truly have a mission. You have a way to have critical thinking. You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the mission very clear for us. He said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I haven't created jinn and ins and jinn and mankind, but to worship me. So we know that the purpose of this life is really to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the main thing. Which means everything has to be channeled towards fulfilling that purpose. Whatever I do, whether I post on social media, whether I make 6-7 seconds, you know, post or make a long video or I participate in an activity, whatever that is, if it doesn't go into fulfilling that mission, then we're missing a lot. We've fallen way behind and we've become complacent with this culture, unfortunately, the culture of individualism and consumerism. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the mission. Udu'u ila sabili rabbika bil hikmati wa mu'idhati al-hasana. Your duty is to call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To call people to Allah azza wa jal. Bil hikmah. With good, give them reminders and that which is good, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, khayru nasi anfa'hum linnas. That my most beloved people to Allah azza wa jal are those who are most beneficial to the most beloved people to Allah azza wa jal are those most beneficial to others. So our mission is really, we need to be active and activist in order to bring that which is best to the people, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. So here's now what I have for you in terms of habits we need to develop, inshallah, azza wa jal, to become serious activists. And that we can find in the Quran in one single ayah, in Surah Taha, which is chapter number 20, ayah number 42. Chapter 20, ayah number 42, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us how we can become really true and genuine activists. Qala Allahu azza wa jal, and just to put the ayah in the context, the context is the story of Musa alayhi salam with his brother Harun. When Musa was commissioned to the message, he had to deal with one of the most notorious people ever existed in the history of mankind, Fir'aun, the Pharaoh of Egypt. And Musa, as he was when he was commissioned for the prophethood, he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for help. He says, my Lord, you know, my brother, he speaks better than me. Could you please commission for the message as well too? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted this wish to Musa alayhi salam. And he sent to Harun. So they both became now messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they were sent to the Fir'aun. The role was very clear and simple. You go to Fir'aun, ask him to give you Bani Israel, take them to the Holy Land. But in the process, obviously, call him to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only Allah azza wa jal. Now, speaking to someone like Fir'aun is not going to be an easy task. No one can say it's going to be an easy task. Now, many of us today, they think what they're going through is hard and difficult. What we're dealing with is impossible mission. SubhanAllah, can you imagine what Musa and Harun had to deal with? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending to Musa and Harun the mission statement for their da'wah and for the purpose of going to the Fir'aun. What did he say to them? قال اذهب اذهب أنت وأخوك بآياتي ولا تنيا في ذكري. One single ayah. اذهب أنت وأخوك بآياتي ولا تنيا في ذكري. In translation, the ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Musa alayhi salam and his brother Harun, go, you and your brother, with my signs, which means the proofs, and do not slacken in my remembrance. Now, let's study this ayah and see what are the five things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering us in this ayah in order to become activists and have a purpose for ourselves in this life. Number one, the first thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Musa alayhi salam, idhhab. Go. Even in the English word go, it's an imperative verb. And maybe it doesn't really show much in English because the grammar is different, but in the Arabic language, idhab, that's an imperative verb. It's a command you give to one person. That means it is your personal mission. So Allah subhanahu, the first thing we need to do here to understand from this verb, that this verb is a call to take action. And not just to take action, to take personal action, which means take personal responsibility. If everyone today is waiting for someone else to do the job, who's going to do it? This is the time to become an activist right now and realize, okay, what am I going to do right now? I have a lot of time in my hand. What else I can do to help people, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala? Even if you could do it online, if you're a teacher, if you're a scholar, if you're an engineer, if you're this, if you're that, whatever that you do, even if you're just a stay-at-home mom, what can I do to help other people, inshallah, in time like this? I have a mission. I need to fulfill that, inshallah, ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Musa alayhi salam, idhab, go. So the first thing he said to him, he says, you go, which means take personal responsibility. I need to become right now an also activist in taking that responsibility in my hand. I'm not going to wait for anybody to do this for me. So stop blaming others for whatever happens in our life. Stop blaming, you know, the coronavirus, blaming China for it or this and that, whatever that we do. Let's right now seize the moment of our time and take personal responsibility in that. And of course, when we do so, we keep going and going and going. Even if people come, you know, come start, you know, bombarding you with all this criticism, my job is just to take my personal responsibility and keep moving, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. So the first thing is you take personal responsibility. Number two, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to him, anta wa akhuka, you and your brother. So the first thing was take personal responsibility. And then second thing right now, look for cooperation. What does that mean? Teamwork. Teamwork. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking us first to take personal responsibility. And then once you become responsible, bring like-minded people with you and start work on a project, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. When it comes to having a teamwork, it destroys the radical culture of individualism. Like, you can't just do everything by yourself. I know a lot of people right now on social media, this is the moment. Why? Because, subhanAllah, everybody's online, everybody's just like doing nothing except watching videos and so on. This is the time to get myself out there, my name out there, and we forget about the mission that it's supposed to be for. If it becomes about you, not about the message, it's a problem. Teamwork. I want to team up with other people, like-minded people, inshallah, like we do over here right now, in order for all of us to get together, inshallah, ta'ala, for good common cause, bidnillahi azza wa jal. Healthy communication with each other, emotional intelligence with one another, support each other's cause, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala, inspire one another. Number three, what we get from this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, idhab anta wa akhuka, you and your brother, and he says, bi ayati, which means with my signs, and this case means proofs. What does that exactly mean? When Allah sent Musa and Harun, what did he tell him? You do it with knowledge. So this is the time to learn. If I'm going to get out there and deliver, inshallah, message to the people, I need to do it with clear signs and clear proofs. That requires for me to spend some time on learning. I need to learn. You become a truth seeker no matter what. There is so much is out there. Some of it is always a fluff, as a matter of fact. But you know what? I need to scrutinize to see what is right and what is wrong. So it's my duty right now, as I go out, inshallah, ta'ala, to start teaching people, reach out to people, to destroy ignorance and become an active in learning, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. Make sure that you do learn and learn no matter what you think, how much knowledge you think you have. Allah says, wa fawqa kulli dhi ilmin alim, above every knowledgeable person, there is someone who's more knowledgeable. Someone is going to be more knowledgeable than you. Keep learning, inshallah, ta'ala. Number four in this ayah, Allah says to Musa and Harun, wa la taniya. اذهب أنت وأخوك بآياتي. Go, you and your brother, with my proofs and my signs. ولا تنيا, and do not slacken. Which means what? Don't be a slacker. There is no time right now. We have no time for this. We're running short on even on life, probably. All Allah knows what's going to happen next and who's going to be the next person, Allah Musta'an. So there is no time to be lazy. This destroys all kind of laziness and should motivate people to build, inshallah ta'ala, healthy habits, bidnillahi azza wa jal. So what do you do in this case? Don't slack. If you think that now you're losing your motivation because you're getting physically unhealthy and tired, then please, exercise. If you now think that, you know what, your mind is not being challenged enough because there is nothing much to do except dealing with little kids at home and this and that, then read and learn something new. Go learn another skill. Or even maybe start, you know, going back again to your family. Build a relationship with your family, inshallah ta'ala. The idea is that you need to start, you know, putting goals and reach these goals, inshallah. Short-term goals, long-term goals. While at home, there is so much I can do with my family, with my friends online, with audience online, I can do a lot. Allah says, wala taniya, don't slack. This is not the time to start, you know, falling short on achieving excellence, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. And the last statement Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is adding to us here in this ayah, he says, qal wala taniya fi dhikri. Fi dhikri means with my remembrance. What does that mean? In the process of becoming an activist, you go out there with teamwork. And adding to this, you're learning all the time. And you keep learning and learning about the dunya and the akhirah. And you try your best to put all the energy out there. Don't forget about yourself. You need to be spiritual. And how do you do that? You connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See, my dear brothers and sisters, spirituality is an individual experience. No matter what you think you get from outside, you know, the world for spirituality, no matter how much you get from these programs and activities and lectures that you watch and you listen to, when it comes to spirituality, it is an individual experience. You need to spend some time for yourself. Fasting can help you. doing tahajjud will help you. Wake up before Fajr. Pray your sunnahs on a regular basis. Stay on wudu. Make adhkar in the morning and the evening. No matter what you think, how strong you think you are, you're going to get weaker. And I need to stay active as well, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters, these are the five messages that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has left for us in one single ayah in Surah Taha, which is again chapter 20, ayah number 42. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to us, idhhab anta wa akhuka bi ayati wa la taniya fi dhikri. Five messages over here. Number one, take personal responsibility. Idhhab, go. Take personal responsibility. Anta wa akhuka. Number two, teamwork. Look for like-minded people and help each other, inshallah, to achieve something good. Number three, bi ayati. My proofs and signs means learning, active learning. Always stay truth seeker, knowledge seeker. Never stop learning, dunya and akhirah. Number four, wala taniya, and don't slack. There's not a time to start slowing down. It's the time to start going up, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. And the last thing, don't forget about yourself. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah azza wa jal make us active in this dunya so we can reap the benefit in the akhirah. And jannatul firdaws al-a'la ya rabbal alameen. And I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to give us the ability to stay strong and stay healthy and stay spiritual in this difficult time. I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to give you all protection from this disease, Ya Rabbil Alameen. For those who feel ill, I ask Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala for quick shifa and recovery for them. I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to have mercy on us, Ya Rabbil Alameen, and protect us all. Jazakum Allahu Khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
Ameen. And Jazakallah khair, Shaykh Yasir Birjas. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from you and reward you immensely for all your efforts.
Ameen.